Birla Industrial and Technological Museum, coming under Ministry of Culture, Government of India, is developing a lot of demonstration lectures for the students. Balloon show is one such show where there are a lot of exciting experiments. Very low cost items we are using and having exciting scientific principles we are explaining in a very lucid manner and with a lot of fun and entertainment. The Birla Museum is very famous for a lot of demonstration lectures, a lot of scientific galleries, with the education is our main motive in a formal, informal way, with a lot of entertainment.
So many balloons. So many balloons. Choose any one. Yeah, says choosing one. Now, here, blood. Will you forget the bottom? Now, yeah. Now, can you tie it up? That's the cat. Wow, so that's good.
Do you want to cut up? Shop to the bottom end.
Hold it. One hand each. Now hold strong. One, two, three, two, three. Welcome to my balloon show.
If air is a mixture of gases, can it be liquefied? Let's see.
I now want to contract the air. And for this, you must know this is liquid nitrogen. And its temperature is minus 196 degrees Celsius.
Three! Wow! Lovely!
If you keep that liquid nitrogen more than 3 seconds, you will get burned.
Come close, see. Nothing happens. Anything? Any problem? Say your
pen,
no problem.
Lovely. No problem.
No problem.
When the temperature of the air drops from around 33 degrees Celsius to minus 196 degrees Celsius, the molecules really slow down. In fact, nitrogen in the air inside the balloon changes its state from gaseous to liquid. So do carbon dioxide and water. Only oxygen stays gaseous, but its molecules move about randomly at greatly reduced speed.
Everybody, please count. Count 1 to 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
When out of the liquid nitrogen bath, the liquefied nitrogen inside the balloon absorbs heat from the atmosphere and vaporizes once again.
See, wow, can you see liquid?
Yes!
Oh my God, that is a liquid. Now you hold it strong.
The molecules pick up speed and resume their vigorous random movement.
They will do themselves. Now, you hold it. Okay, you hold it. Strong, huh?
The atmospheric pressure is much, much higher than the pressure of air inside the frozen balloon. The balloon crumbles under this huge difference in pressure. But when taken out of the bath and put back in the atmosphere, it regains its original shape.
I have a friend, Saluni. He wants to go into this
Now, you hold this girl. She's doing it. She's telling me. Very good. Good, good. You are a good follower. Just like a... Don't get scared.
The burning paper consumes all the oxygen in the conical flask. The number of molecules in the flask reduced by about 21%. Some of the remaining molecules also get heated up and escape from the sides. So the pressure inside the flask drops drastically. A partial vacuum is created inside the conical flask. Pressure of outside air pushes the balloon in.
How can I take it out? How can I take it out? Yes, yes.
Oh my God.
I'm just going to use a straw. And now see what I do. I keep the straw here. Can you see? Now I give some extra pressure through the straw into this, at this conical glass. This is known as conical glass. Say lovely. Conical glass.
If a pressure difference had sucked the balloon inside the flask, a pressure difference will push it out of the flask as well.
I'm joking. Now see, I'm big.
To find an adequate explanation of even a very simple experiment is not easy. I mean, that's what I have experienced while doing this kind of work, and I think you will also agree on that.
Exactly.
So I was just thinking about that experiment where you put a burning paper inside a conical flask and then you block the top of the flask with a balloon.
Yes.
The usual explanation is that the oxygen gets burnt up, creates a partial vacuum, and this thing goes in.
Exactly.
But you see, there are two points. One is the carbon dioxide, which is produced after burning that, it stays. There.
Yes.
At least most of it would stay there. It's heavy, it will go down and all that. So, but then why does it go in?
Exactly.
Don't you think that it's the heated up air inside which expands and come out of the flask?
Yes, sir.
That also creates a lot of pressure from outside?
Exactly. And sir, you know that, sir, when the carbon dioxide is hot, it is lighter than air. So along with the other parts of air, right, it is also getting heated up. Air is also getting heated up and expanding. So they, some part of them is going out. And that makes a partial vacuum inside the conical flask and outside air pressure.
A part of carbon dioxide also can get out.
Yes, yes.
But this probably completes the explanation,
yes, sir,
which is not very easy to find
exactly,
out.
Okay. Exactly.
Air comes out of the blower at a very high speed. According to Bernoulli's principle, higher the speed, lower the pressure. Let us see what this high-speed jet of air can do to a balloon.
I would love to see.
The pressure within the stream of air is less than that outside, according to Bernoulli's principle. Therefore, the balloon is pressed towards the middle of the stream as the air from the blower curves around the balloon like a river flowing around a rock.
And the question is, it seems to me that you are diving from about 30,000 foot airplane and you are falling. All the carbon is due to air pressure going down. Now see what I do. It's a pipe balloon. It's a pipe balloon. So many balloons are here. Which one you prefer? You.
just see. এর মধ্যে এই বেলুনটার মধ্যে একটু গ্যাস ভরে দাও. এনা এনা সি এনা.
When your mother is cooking in the garden, there is a fire. Why the fire is not going back through the pipe and making the cylinder blast?
To burn a substance, it is not enough to raise its temperature to the ignition point. Oxygen must also be present. The process of combustion is essentially a process of oxidation. At the mouth of the tube, these conditions are satisfied, but not inside the tube.
Can you celebrate your birthday on the surface of the moon, lighting the candles on the cake? Can you do? Why?
Because there is no oxygen, no air. No oxygen, no combustion.
Now see, I just keep it here. See this.
It seems one of the balloons is a hunter and the other is hunted. Would the hunter be able to annihilate its neighbor? Blowing between the balloons will increase the speed of air. According to Bernoulli's principle, as velocity of a fluid increases, its pressure decreases. Pressure from the outer region will push the balloons together. But to increase the difference in pressure to an appreciable value, one has to blow really hard.
Come on! I need more power means no, get ready. Come here kids, are you ready? Now see, I will blow and very high pressure, high velocity, low pressure, low velocity, high pressure. Now see, are you ready? Come on. Why don't you the light? This is my balloon show. I think that's...
How to make science easier in case of the students? Just with the easily available and very cheap materials. Now, today, we have introduced one new show with that cheap and easily available material, balloons. Wherever you go, I think that you can get a balloon. This easily available balloon can help us a lot to understand the very laws, theories, and principles of science very easily. Why you have chosen balloon? This balloon, wherever you go, I think that you can find one balloon. This is very easily available. Here, we are showing you in a very funny way what is called pressure, what is force, what is friction, what is inertia, Bernoulli's principle, Archimedes' principle, Laplace's principles, Laplace's law.
Yes, that's an amazing experiment. You will love to see this.
Shona, আমি যদি ছেড়ে দিই দুটো আঙুল, তাহলে এখান থেকে আর এখানে বা এখান থেকে আর এখানে যাবে? কতদিন বলবে যে ছোটটা বড় হবে, বড়টা ছোট হবে? আর তো এরকম বলছে না, একজন বলবে। কতজন বলবে যে বড়টা বড় হবে, ছোটটা ছোট হবে? কতজন বলছো যে দুটোই সমান হবে? হাত ধরো, দুটোই সমান হবে। 1, 2, amazing. Ali? Oh my god. Come on, boy. Amazing.
That experiment where you have two inflated balloons, one big, one small,
exactly,
at the end of a tube, air flows from the smaller one to the bigger one. That's
exactly
very counterintuitive.
Yeah.
We don't expect that to happen. So do you explain it on this thing?
Yeah. I explained it.
It's because the pressure inside a bubble is inversely proportional to its radius. So the one with smaller radius will have more pressure in
it
than the bigger one. And it will behave the way it
exactly.
did.
Yeah,
that's also very interesting.
Very interesting. Yeah, that's
counterintuitive.
We're doing it, with this Pani experiment.
Yeah, it doesn't happen with your water level and all that.
No, I mean,
the general feeling is that this will come down, this will go up. And
that's why, sir, you know that whenever at the time of inflation of any balloon, at the beginning, we need to give some more pressure. But when one it is started inflating, it is a bit less pressure we need to go. That's
very. That's a very interesting observation. Yes. Yeah, that's the way it happens.
At the time of whenever we are starting to blow it, we are giving more pressure.
Yeah.
But when it started, inflating, when it is bit inflated,
partially inflated,
I need not that amount of pressure that I need. I am giving from my mouth.
Exactly.
See.
Exactly.
Comparatively, bit easier. See. Now more pressure. Now. Less pressure.
Even less.
Now it is easier. Now it is easier. It's easier.
Yeah, we all felt it, but you have pointed out
we
the reason
it.
For that.
We experience it in our daily life. Yes.
That's true.
Amazing. Good quality. There is no magnetic. This is my balloon. Wow. We can imagine it as a UFO, unidentified flying object. Now, then who wants to be the alien from the UFO? No. I went to call her. Come here. That girl. You or you, anyone come. Now, kya ra ra? Give it up. Now, again I got these two plastic bottles. These two plastic bottles. And now, in this regard, do not smile, do not laugh, right?
Are you ready? Are you ready? So, she's ready. She is ready. I will do with this too. Now don't smile. Don't laugh. No. This video. Don't! I told her not to laugh! Please do not laugh, huh? Be steady. Good girl. Good girl, do not laugh. Look at your friend. Wow, she's looking good!
Don't laugh. Be careful.
By squeezing the plastic cup, one is expelling some air from inside. Then it is pressed against a balloon or human skin, such that no air can get inside the cup. When released, the cup inflates a little. The air inside expands by a small amount and the pressure drops. Outside pressure, which is actually the atmospheric pressure, presses the cup against the balloon or human face. Whether a nail will pierce a balloon or someone's skin is determined by the pressure at the tip of the pin. Pressure is force divided by area. The area of the tip of the pin is very small. So, when a force is applied over the tip, the pressure at the tip is very high. The nail pierces the skin of the balloon.
the scene of as much as 1,000 pins.
When there are, say, 1,000 pins, then the total force will be distributed over all of them, and a single pin will have 1,000th of the earlier pressure at its tip. Such a small pressure is not able to pierce the balloon or the human skin.
Pressure equals
force
upon
area.
Very comfortable. Could you please?
So we have reason to fear a single pin, but not 1,000 pins.
দুটো ইলাস্টিক সুতো দিয়ে এইটা দেওয়া আছে বার, যার পেছনে একটা লোহা দেওয়া আছে দেখতে পাচ্ছ আয়রন, আর এর উপরে তিনটে পিন আছে। কোনোভাবে যদি এটা উপরে যায় বেলকে ফাটাবে না। সি ওয়ান টু আর রেডি, ভালো করে দেখো যাই ছাড়বো এটা উপরে চলে যাবে এক্সপেক্টেড। ওয়ান টু মজা করলাম, হবে হবে চিন্তা করবো।
And now please, I'd like to show you this.
When the wooden frame is released from the hands, it falls freely through air. The block attached to the frame also falls freely. A falling body has no weight, so the elastic bands holding the block become loose and they shrink. The trick is in letting the whole system fall straight down. It all happens in a split second. Yeah, Tarun, I was wondering about one thing. The way you explained that experiment where the, you know, you let the frame drop goes up.
Yeah.
This is the one.
Yeah.
You explained it the following way, that when it becomes weightless while falling freely, this small piece of wood releases the tension, therefore the elastics contract.
Yes.
And the nails hit the balloon.
Yes.
But I was just wondering, see, this is not exactly free fall, no?
Exactly.
Air is there, air.
Obviously, air friction is there.
So, I cannot quantify how much, but. The bigger frame, the heavier frame, will fall a little faster than the small piece of wood.
Exactly.
And if you allow it enough length to fall through, then the small piece of wood would go up and hit the balloon.
Yes, yes.
You agree?
I agree. But one thing is, what I wanted to mean is that whenever something is falling, it loses its weight. Here, what I tried to mean it that, whenever this also falling along when which is tied up with these two strings, elastic strings, maybe that it is falling a bit faster, but I wanted to mean that it is losing its weight, and due to elasticity it is getting contracted and it is pulling it up and it is making the balloon burst.
Yes, I mean that's perfectly ordered that's nice, but I was just wondering whether this effect is also taking place or not, maybe a part of it due to
exactly that. Now see, I'm just letting it fall and observe it. One, two, go. Go.
This is a balloon. This blue one, it is just hanging from the ceiling. And the green one is a helium balloon, just floating from the floor.
The air-filled balloon is pulled by the force of gravity, just like all of us. The helium balloon, on the other hand, experiences a buoyant force. It gets an upward push from the surrounding air. This is because density of helium is much less than density of air.
Now, if you are inside a car, hit the car, suddenly starts moving, you go forward or backward?
Backward.
Suppose that it is in motion, you just push the back, it will go forward or back? Yes.
And now, I push it and see in which direction the green moves and in which direction the blue moves. Balloon. One, two, go! Which direction it is going? Ahead, it is going back. See, see. Oh, I'll show you again. I boom! This one go ahead, this one go back.
The air-filled balloon follows the laws of inertia, just like our own bodies. It tends to continue moving forward even when its vehicle is abruptly brought to rest.
This will go back. See, when it is going, I stop it! And it goes back. One, two, you go, stop! It is going back and it is going ahead.
The question is, why is the helium balloon not following the laws of inertia?
Hey, Baba, where is it? Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. Ready? Here it is. Shut up! See?
The helium balloon in air behaves in a similar way to the air bubble in water. The helium balloon floats in air because helium is lighter than air. If you cut off its string, it will float right to the top of the atmosphere. Now, when the glass vehicle is pushed forward, the air inside the glass box feel a backward push because of their inertia. This sets up a tiny pressure gradient with slightly denser air at the back and slightly thinner air at the fore. The helium balloon has a tendency to move towards the lower pressure, and so it moves forward. That experiment with ordinary and helium balloon is a very beautiful one. It's really beautiful. Now, just one more thing I would like to point out. I hope you've seen it somewhere, that if you move in a car,
exactly,
and you have two balloons, one ordinary and the other one filled with helium, then also this effect can be observed and more pronouncedly.
Exactly.
I mean, you accelerate, you brake, you turn left or right, at each movement, this will be demonstrated.
Yeah.
It's very beautiful.
Very beautiful, and the effect is really nice. And as I am doing it on stage, so I made this box with wheels, and as much as possible, we just try to make them understood that it works this way.
That was a very intelligent innovation.
Exactly.
I would say.
Thank you.
Two cups up with the help of one balloon. You can do this.
The inflating balloon displaces some of the air from the hollow of the cups and makes room for itself. The rims of the two cups get firmly attached to the inflated balloon. Partial vacuum inside the cups and the friction between the rims of the cups and the surface of the balloons hold the cups in suspension.
So, wow, lovely. One, two.
Not can anybody just help me? No, that way. You are telling me that how can I lift this whole glass up with the smell, with the help of the small glittering balloon in seconds?
The first is put the balloon on top, okay? Let the air go home.
It seems that this is going to be a variation of the conical flask experiment. The pressure inside the glass is much lower than atmospheric pressure because the burning paper has consumed the oxygen and some of the heated air has escaped. Because the rim of the glass has tightly fitted onto the surface of the balloon, air from outside cannot rush into the glass. It is an airtight contact. So the atmosphere presses into the glass and holds it up. The balloon has almost got vacuum sealed with the glass. But once the balloon is out, air rushes in.
I started my show with this riddle. I will end my show with this riddle. Kneel down first. Now, look at this. Look at the balloon. Now, see, 1, 2. Get close. Finish. Once more. Get close. Come on. 1, 2, 3. And now, just hold with 3 hands. That. Now, I will say 1, 2, 3. And you said balloon show, then clap for the men. Did you enjoy my show?
Yeah!
Did you learn anything from my show?
Yeah!
Hold with 3 hands, 1 hand each. Don't move, don't worry. Nothing will happen. Now get back, just keeping this, just press towards this wall. Keep pressing. No. Everybody at the back. Put your hand at the back. Now 1, 2. Just hold. 1, 2, 3! Ah. 1, 2, 3! Lovely! Thank you so very much. Thank you.